is News 3 Now at 10.
Thank you for joining us tonight. Day one of the Democratic National Convention is just wrapping up.
Speakers tonight included the former First Lady Michelle Obama, Senator Bernie Sanders, the last Democrat to exit the presidential primary. Maddie O'Neill is here, and she has a recap. Maddie.
Well, tonight's theme was We the People, with a focus on unity, with plenty of calls to unify together to get President Trump out of the White House come November. Now, of course, the convention didn't look like what we might have expected at the beginning of the year. Instead of fanfare, thousands of people coming to Milwaukee, it's mostly virtual with video from satellite locations across the country. Now, may it be from everyday Americans or elected officials, we heard criticism toward Trump, with speakers saying he's dividing the American people. Former First Lady Michelle Obama is urging the country to unite behind Joe Biden and reminded them that their vote matters. Before that, Senator Bernie Sanders said the price of Donald Trump getting reelected is too high.
To heal the soul of our nation, Joe Biden will end the hate and division Trump has created. He will stop the demonization of immigrants, the coddling of white nationalists, the racist dog whistling, the religious bigotry, and the ugly attacks on women.
Innocent people of color continue to be murdered, stating the simple fact that a Black life matters is still met with derision from the nation's highest office. Because whenever we look to this White House for some leadership or consolation or any semblance of steadiness, what we get instead is chaos, division, and a total and utter lack of empathy.
Now tonight, there was a large focus on racial injustice and policing in the 2 hours, as well as criticism toward the current presidential administration's response to the pandemic, with some speakers blaming Trump for the deaths of Americans. We also heard elected officials talk about the importance of the United States Postal Service and the role it can play in voting this November. Also tonight, George Floyd's brother spoke earlier in the convention, calling for the continuation of the fight for justice and a moment of silence.
One of the more unusual speakers at tonight's event was former Ohio Governor John Kasich. He was one of three Republicans to speak in a show of bipartisanship for Joe Biden and his running mate. Their message, country over party.
I'm a lifelong Republican, but that attachment holds second place to my responsibility to my country. That's why I've chosen to appear at this convention. In normal times, something like this would probably never happen. But these are not normal times. I'm proud of my Republican heritage. It's the party of Lincoln, who reflected its founding principles of unity and a higher purpose. But what I have witnessed these past 4 years belies those principles. Many of us.
Looking ahead to other speakers this week, tomorrow they will include Dr. Jill Biden, Joe's wife, former President Bill Clinton, former Secretary of State John Kerry, and Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer. On Wednesday, Senator Kamala Harris will accept the nomination for vice president. Former President Barack Obama will speak, as well as Hillary Clinton, Speaker Nancy Pelosi, and Wisconsin Governor Tony Evers. And then on Thursday, the final day of the convention, Joe Biden will accept the Democratic nomination for president. Wisconsin Senator Tammy Baldwin will give a speech, as well as former South Bend, Indiana Mayor Pete Buttigieg.
And while the convention is mostly virtual this year, of course, there are still security measures in place in Milwaukee for what is happening there. There's fencing installed all around the Wisconsin Center earlier today, and it'll stay up through Friday. The security perimeter is actually much smaller than originally planned after the convention was significantly downsized. The DNC's control room will still be in the city inside the Wisconsin Center, and Secret Service is in town to help protect it. President Donald Trump taking advantage of his opponent Joe Biden not being in Wisconsin for the DNC. The president gave a speech in Oshkosh today, and our Amy Reid shows us what he told his supporters.
As the signs next to the stage would suggest, Trump wanted to focus a lot of today on jobs and the economy. But speaking for about an hour in Oshkosh, the president was able to touch on a lot more than that.
We replaced probably the worst trade deal ever, NAFTA, with the brand new USMCA, which puts us right at the top. And now Canada and Mexico are doing what's right for our country.
President Donald Trump touted his record on trade during his campaign rally in Oshkosh Monday, but he didn't stop at what he's done. He also took digs at Vice President Joe Biden and the Obama administration's handling of H1N1.
Swine flu, though, Look at his ratings in Gallup. Check them out. They gave them really bad ratings.
Trump said inaccurately that the U.S. has better numbers than almost all other countries at handling the coronavirus pandemic. His supporters told us he's doing the best he can at managing the response.
I think he's doing a great job. We have to remember something. Put yourself in his place. What would you do? How could you make it better? And most people don't have any answer for that one.
Barbara Avery said she's voting for him again because she said he's kept all his promises. And Robert Wilcox said he likes the tax cuts, but he still feels the same as he did in 2016.
I was very upset with President Obama, and I'm a Christian. And when I prayed to God, I prayed for a president that would speak the truth, show the lies of the media, and be not hurt by their attacks. And that's what it got.
Inside, the president wrapped up his speech encouraging his supporters to vote in person or absentee.
So we have to win the election. We can't play games. Get out and vote. Do those beautiful absentee ballots, or just make sure your vote gets counted. Make sure, because the only way we're going to lose this election as if the election is rigged. Remember that.
This is the Trump campaign's first stop in the state for the week, with his son and the vice president returning later this week. Reporting in Oshkosh, Amy Reid, News 3 Now.
In his speech, the president confirmed he'll be accepting the nomination for the Republican Party from the White House, which the ethics office said is permitted under the Hatch Act.
State Democrats say the president's visit today was nothing more than an attempt to distract people from the convention happening this week. Senator Tammy Baldwin says the president has failed Wisconsin.
Our economy is hurting. Our state is hurting. We're tired of the photo ops. We need leadership. We deserve more. We deserve a president who actually cares. And we're going to get that when we elect Joe Biden as president and Kamala Harris as vice president.
And a reminder, News 3 Now and Channel3000.com will have complete coverage of the convention through Thursday night.
Let's turn things over to weather now. Meteorologist Dana Fulton with our first warm forecast. Dana.
This afternoon and this evening, really pleasant and sunny outside, but we did start the day off with a few little light isolated showers passing through that also gifted us with a nice rainbow briefly across the sky. Afternoon highs with that sunshine in the low 80s. We started the day off in the 50s, and temperatures for the next few days are going to be very similar. Doppler track is quiet right now. We're not expecting any light showers for tonight over early Tuesday. All of that rain is now well to the south in central Illinois and Indiana. High temperatures tomorrow, close to 80 again, in the upper 70s with mostly sunny skies. We'll stay pleasant through your work week with a few chances for showers creeping back in as we look ahead to the weekend. We'll take a closer look at the full 10-day in just a few minutes.
Dana, thank you. A fire in Portage tonight destroys a garage and severely damages a home. This is the second large fire for the city in less than a week. Happened on West Albert around 5 tonight. The fire chief tells us there were 3 children in the home at the time. They were able to get out safely. Departments from across the region were called in for mutual aid.
When we have a structure fire like that, or like this, it helps to have more people on scene to help put out fires. You can switch crews around. You're not wearing your guys out, because this is our second one this week.
As you can see, the garage destroyed. The fire chief says the home is no longer habitable. Portage Police Department says the Red Cross is helping the family.
Getting a look at our updated coronavirus numbers in Wisconsin. State and county health officials confirm more than 630 new cases today. It's a slight decline from yesterday. The positivity rate also dropped today. Over the last 24 hours, 7.6% of tests came back positive. That's about even with the 7-day average. New tonight, the city of Beloit says a city worker has tested positive for the coronavirus. According to a press release, the city was notified of the positive test on Friday. Contact tracing has been completed, and the employee has had no in-person contact with the general public through work. This is the third Beloit City worker to test positive for the disease. The University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill abruptly decided it will no longer hold in-person classes on campus after about 130 students and a handful of staff tested positive for COVID-19 in the first week since classes began. On Friday, the university identified 2 clusters of cases at student residences chances. Then yesterday, UNC announced another cluster at an off-campus fraternity house.
As a debate over whether to send students to school in person the next few weeks continues, one local doctor is saying he is comfortable sending his daughters to school. Speaking on News 3 Now this morning, Dr. Jeff Potthoff says his young girls will be learning in a hybrid model at their school. The key, he says, is that he's comfortable with the school's social distancing plans. He says every parent should be asking questions for their specific school district to determine if it's safe.
You want to look at masking requirements. Certainly, robust masking policies are very important. Sanitation policies, how are they going to do distancing at pickup, drop-off? And then particularly if your school's going to have it, lunch and recess can be tricky times. So you have to look at that.
Dr. Potthoff says there's still a risk for schools reopening for in-person classes, but says there's also a risk in kids not getting the in-person instruction they need. He says the answers for every district are going to be different.
Still to come tonight, your full forecast for the week ahead. But first, Dane County announces its largest land purchase of the year. What it'll be used for next on News 3 Now at 10.
Papa Murphy's, we need seriously, chop seriously, and shred seriously. Because we're serious about Tuesdays, even if you're not. Every Tuesday, get a large pizza for just $10. Papa Murphy's, change the way you pizza.
Govan Cars Grand Opening Sale, beautiful Middleton. 2017 Nissan Sentras, Hyundai Elantras for only $79.95 or $129 per month.
That's right, buy 2017 Nissan Sentras and Hyundai Elantras for only $79.95 or $129 per month.
Govan Cars is selling 2018 Kia Fortes for only $89.95 or $149 per month.
Hurry in today and just ask for my dad, Don the Dealman Govan.
Or my daughter, Crystal the Pistol Govan.
You gotta go to Govan. GovanCars.com.
These deals are amazing.
I know. How do we get them?
Okay, we have to be very subtle about asking. Like this.
Like this?
No, like this.
Actually, you don't have to do any of that. We have great deals for everyone.
Even without the...
You would have gotten it anyway.
Cool.
If you've forgotten what a fair deal sounds like, let us remind you. Switch to U.S. Cellular and get $700 off the latest smartphones with no activation fee. U.S. Cellular. Upgrade to fair.
You don't just wear jeans, you live and work in jeans, and you want them at prices you can afford. Right now at Blaine's Farm and Fleet, all jeans are on sale. Get unbeatable deals on top brands of denim, workwear, and more. Like these women's Gloria Vanderbilt jeans, just $21.99. Men's and women's Carhartt K87 pocket tees are two for $25. And save big on these men's Timberland Pro work boots, only $49.99.
Find value at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Money can't buy you happiness. Nonsense. $6 can buy you two Arby's sandwiches. That's two happinesses. Arby's, we have the meat.
Come in today for Rubens' annual leather event. Rubens has received generous discounts from all our fine leather suppliers. Natuzzi, American Leather, and many other manufacturers have allowed Rubens to give you up to 10% off on all leather furniture. Rubens' downtown store and Westside store have many pieces that are available for immediate delivery. Remember, all interior design services are complimentary. Stop into either Rubens today for our leather event.
We're using movement as a means to educate.
How can students schooling at home this fall also work in some physical education? We'll have ideas for parents and kids to get bodies moving and help build positive social skills as well on the next News 3 Now this morning.
You're watching News 3 Now at 10.
Nearly 300 Pizza Hut locations will be closing. Last month, one of the chain's biggest franchises, NPC International, filed for bankruptcy. And on Monday, NPC announced an agreement with Pizza Hut's owner to close a quarter of its restaurants. Other NPC locations will be sold. The announcement did not say which locations will be closed or when. Two men have been arrested in the unsolved 2002 murder of Run DMC's Jam Master Jay. The U.S. Attorney for the Eastern District of New York York says Carl Jordan Jr. and Ronald Washington have been charged with murder in the death. The pioneering DJ of the hip-hop group, whose real name was Jason Mizell, was shot and killed at a recording studio in New York City's Queensboro on October 30th, 2002. He was 37 years old.
A warning for anyone planning a trip up to the Apostle Islands. The National Park Service says there has been an increase in what they call unusual bear activity, and because of that, access to the trails and beaches on Oak Island is now prohibited. However, overnight docking for self-contained boaters remains open, but they are warned to be vigilant about proper food storage and eat and cook only on their boat. Beginning next Monday, the Capital City Trail will be closed between Knob Hill Road and Southtown Drive for sewer replacement. You can see it here in the red. That closure is expected to last about 6 weeks. Crews are hoping to reopen the trail by September 25th. A signed detour will be posted.
More local news now. Dane County is making its biggest effort this year to protect land and reduce flooding potential. The county has purchased land at the intersection of Badger Creek Mill and the Sugar River. The goal is to provide water resources, recreational areas, and help prevent flooding in the future.
Not only does this increase wildlife habitat, natural habitat, recreational opportunities, it helps prevent flooding and it provides filtration and reduces runoff to help keep our waterways clean too. So when we focus our resources in places like this from which we get a multitude of benefits, it's really not only great stewardship of the natural environment, but it's the best stewardship of tax dollars.
Existing croplands will be converted to prairie space, which will reduce runoffs into streams by 70%.
Beloit's new Amazon Fulfillment Center is now open. This is video from earlier in the year when the building was being built. The company welcomed new employees to the facility yesterday for its first day of operation. According to a news release, more than 500 full-time employees now work at the center. Employees will work to pack and ship large items like patio furniture, bicycles, large household goods, and sports equipment, among other things. Amazon says there are still job openings available as well at the fulfillment center. The Interior Secretary today announced plans for an oil and gas leasing program on the Arctic National Wildlife Refuge in Alaska, which clears the way for drilling there. Secretary David Bernhardt called the plans a, quote, new chapter in American energy independence. It makes good on a 2017 law that makes oil and gas development one of the purposes of the refuge. But, of course, the move isn't without controversy, and the plans are certain to be met with legal challenges. Environmental activists worry drilling there could hurt the environment and make the climate crisis even worse.
California's Death Valley hit 130 degrees yesterday, shattering the August record, not only for the region, but also for all of North America. The reading is the third hottest temperature recorded on Earth and the hottest since the 1930s. It comes as the western United States continues to see scorching weather from Arizona to Montana. Dana, certainly something that we have never experienced here.
We have not experienced that. The last time we hit 130 in North America was in 1931. So, again, 1930s. Quite a bit of time since it's been that warm, and we're gonna leave that warm air in California. It is gonna be warm for us for the next few days, but thankfully, seasonably warm outside. Temperatures will stay close to average for afternoon highs and for overnight lows. We don't have any rain for most of the week. It's not until late Friday, and for Saturday, those shower and thunderstorm chances will start to grow back into the area. Overnight, mostly clear and comfortable. Temperatures will drop to the 50s for overnight lows. North of the Dells, we could see overnight lows in the upper 40s. Tomorrow afternoon, sunny skies with highs in the upper 70s. More of a breeze from the north, so not quite as warm outside, but still very pleasant. Temperatures for early Wednesday will be in the mid-50s for overnight lows, and then Wednesday afternoon, yet again, hitting 80 for those afternoon highs. It's not until late Friday our shower chances develop as we take a broad look for Friday into Saturday. We'll start the day off with sunshine. Later in the evening, a little bit of cloud coverage building in with our shower chances developing mainly after midnight, and continuing for much of the day on Saturday. We'll have dry hours mixed in, but notice those shower chances in the afternoon and evening. Could see some quick heavy rainfall moments. Those storms, though, push east, and by Sunday, we're back to a dry forecast. For Sunday, we'll be back to partly sunny skies. Now, a little bit of rain, certainly a good thing for us right now. It's a little dry outside. We're abnormally dry towards La Crosse, so starting to officially get on our drought monitor. The rest of southern Wisconsin, not quite there just yet, but we don't have a lot of rain in the the forecast. So it's something we're going to be monitoring over the next 10 days. And our friends off to the west in Iowa, even into the southeast quarter of Minnesota, they're also under that drought status right now. And they are also not expecting to see rain over the next 10 days, or not a lot of rain developing. As our precipitation chances, as we look 6 to 10 days out, very likely we will be trending below average. So keeping a close eye on the garden or just your lawn over the next few days, a good idea as things start to get just a little dried out. Our temperature trend, we're going to keep the warmer air off to the west. Not likely we'll be above or below average, so we're staying in a spot pretty close to average for the next several days. And that lines up with what we're looking at for our 10-day. 77 the high for tomorrow, mostly sunny skies. Partly sunny for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday with a very slow and small warming trend. We'll be in the low 80s by Friday, but still very close to average. Our shower chances developing Friday night towards morning for Saturday, and then the chance for showers and thunderstorms throughout the day on Saturday. Looking ahead to next week, we'll be mostly sunny for Sunday and Monday, and then partly sunny for the middle of the week with high temperatures dropping back a bit in the mid to upper 70s for the middle of the week and overnight lows in the 50s. But we do have that one small chance for rain, and that's about it. So. The garden might need a little quick drink from the hose, just a little extra water because Mother Nature's not bringing it in.
Everything needs a drink.
Everything's a little dry right now,
crunchy.
Getting a little crisp.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Thank you.
Well, just ahead in sports, the Bucks, they swept through the first round of the playoffs last year. Why they say that result really means nothing this year. Zach's in next with sports.
Now, First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Buy a select 2020 Volkswagen today, and you won't pay any interest for the next 6 years. Click, call, or come by your Volkswagen dealer today and get 0% APR financing for 72 months on select 2019 and 2020 models.
Your eyes are everything. They're how you see the world and connect with others. At Shopko Optical, your eyes are everything to us too, which is why we offer everything to help you see better and look better. A huge selection of designer frames, convenient locations, and experienced optometrists. We're Shopko Optical. Right now, get 50% off lenses with the purchase of any frames.
Welcome to the all-new dwellings.
Dear summer, how do I make the most of you? Do I kick back and relax? Or climb new mountains? I could go and get dirty. Or switch into new lanes. One thing's for sure, it's gonna be great. Can't wait. Toyota.
Right now, you can get $1,500 customer cash on a new 2020 Highlander or Highlander Hybrid. Toyota.
They're under 24 hours away from tipping off their first-round playoff matchup against the Magic. Now, last year, Milwaukee took care of Detroit in the first round in four games. And even though the Bucks swept the Magic in the regular season this year, they know nothing is a guarantee in the playoffs, especially in this year's bubble.
This is kind of brand new. We can't just expect we're going to walk in and sweep this team because we swept them 1-8 last year. It's a whole new season. It's a whole, you know, different type of game being played with the atmosphere and the home court advantage and whatnot. So we just got to be prepared to do us.
We're a pretty self-motivated team. We know what our goal is. Everyone's bought in. And so we know we're here to do a job. I think everyone's very excited to get on the floor Tuesday.
Tuesday is game one against the Magic, and not many people are expecting the series go further than game four, so here are the Bucks' first four games in the playoffs. Last year at this time, Packers head coach Matt LaFleur wasn't able to do much. He had a walking boot on after tearing his Achilles, This year, he's back on 2 feet during training camp, and even though that left calf muscle isn't up to his standards or A.J. Dillon's, 2 days into camp, LaFleur has already been more hands-on, throwing to DBs and warming up with Aaron Jones, which makes year two for the head coach way more fun.
That's why you get into coaching, you know, to those relationships and to teach with your guys, being out on the grass. And obviously when you're able to move around, it makes it a lot easier and a lot more fun. So I'm just really glad that, you know, we've got a great doctor here in Green Bay.
Other news from day two of Packers camp, Aaron Rodgers threw his first interception of camp to Christian Kirksey, and the Packers will go full pads tomorrow. And in case you missed it yesterday, Joe Pavelski went crazy on the ice against the Flames. The former Badger scored not once, not twice, but three times, including a goal with 11.9 seconds left in the game to send it to overtime, where the Stars would eventually win. With the hat trick, Pavelski now has scored 53 playoff goals in his career. We'll be right back.
Challenge Talbot from the right dot, beat him, and Dallas is back in front.
Shoes don't need to be expensive. Rogan's has put together a special sale group of kids' shoes that are just $25. $25? We're getting more.
Selection, service, name brands, and the second pair is half price. Visit online at rogansshoes.com.
Get the refrigerator you've always wanted now at the Brothers Main Big Big Deal Refrigerator Sale. Save big on the latest from GE. French doors, black stainless, and smart refrigerators, all with 0% financing up to 18 months. And you'll get our risk-free 30-day price satisfaction guarantee. We make it easy to be confident in your new refrigerator. It's the Big Big Deal Refrigerator Sale, with more selection, more savings, and more big, big confidence only at the Brothers Main, your local store for more since 1938.
Culver's is a family restaurant. To me, that means being the place that puts a smile on everyone's face. We're famous for our cook-to-order butter burgers and frozen custard made daily inside our restaurants. But we've always believed more menu options mean more ways to brighten your day. We source the finest chicken to bring you our tenders and chicken sandwiches. And our cheese curds. They're a Wisconsin tradition we're proud to share with you. So take the next meal shift off and let us take care of you. Welcome to Delicious.
We asked real customers what they really love about Spectrum Internet and TV.
Spectrum Internet has the fastest speeds for everything I do.
There is no turning wheel. It's immediate.
Spectrum is the fastest. Bam.
Get the fastest download speeds with the most reliable performance with Spectrum Internet, delivering starting speeds of 200 megabits. That's more than enough for all your devices for $44.99 a month. Call 833-906-4499.
I can't get over how much on-demand Spectrum has. I can literally watch a new movie every night.
I got all my shows, and he's got all his shows.
With the Spectrum TV app, I can watch live TV anywhere. It's perfect.
Add Spectrum TV and enjoy more free HD and more free on-demand. Plus, use the Spectrum TV app to watch live TV on the go, all from $44.99 a month. Call 833-906-4499.
The fact that they don't have contracts, that says a lot about their service.
Get Spectrum Internet and TV from $44.99 a month each with no contracts. Install Spectrum services yourself. Get a self-installation kit shipped right to your home. Call 833-906-4499.
The Ford Summer Sales Event is here with great offers on a huge selection, like 0% APR financing for 72 months across the Ford lineup. And get peace of mind with the Ford Promise. It's summer, so grab the family and head out. It's easier now during the Ford Summer Sales Event. Right now, get 0% APR financing for 72 months, plus the peace of mind of the Ford Promise. See your local Ford dealer today.
At Pick and Save, we give you more ways to save on the fresh you love, like the Pick and Save app. It combines personalized coupons, fuel points, and weekly sales for the best deals. From meat, to fruits and veggies, to milk, to whatever is in that. We've always given you more ways to save, and now those savings are even better than ever. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
Check it out.
It'd be crazy to do this drug.
But even crazier to do that drug.
Drive sober on your wheels.
And we mean all your wheels.
kept my receipt from last time I came to Rogan's to save even more on back to school for my kids. The shoes I'm getting today are half price. I get the best savings for my family at Rogan's.
Selection, service, name brands, and the second pair is half price. Visit online at rogansshoes.com.
This portion of News 3 Now is sponsored by Shopko Optical. You're watching News 3 Now at 10.
And Dana's back. Final check of the forecast.
Temperatures tonight will drop to the 50s again, mid-50s for our overnight lows. Tomorrow, mostly sunny with highs in the upper 70s. We'll be partly sunny for Wednesday through Friday with temperatures in the 80s. And our chance for showers and thunderstorms will develop overnight Friday and through the day on Saturday. We'll have the chance for showers and storms. Temperatures will stay close to 80 degrees for the weekend. And for next week, by the middle of the week, we'll be in the mid to upper 70s with partly sunny skies. But not a lot of rain chances as we look ahead through the 10 days. So things are going to stay a little dry outside. We'll be keeping, again, a close eye on the ground. See if that drought status creeps back in anymore. We're knock on wood. We don't want that developing for us.
Dana, thanks. And thanks for joining us for News 3 Now at 10.
Do something good. Be well. And we'll see you back here tomorrow.
Shoes don't need to be expensive. Rogan's has put together a special sale group of kids' shoes that are just $25. $25? We're getting more.
Selection, service, name brands, and the second pair is half price. Visit online at RoganShoes.com.
Now, a WISC-TV editorial with editorial director Neil Heinen.
It is an embarrassing indictment of the petty politics of the Wisconsin legislature that Don Crim's title remains secretary designee of the Department of Safety and Professional Services. Republican legislative leaders Voss and Fitzgerald no doubt continue to revel in the disrespect for both Crim and Governor Evers. But their mean-spirited and vengeful conniptions got old long ago, and now they're just juvenile and irresponsible. To her credit, Crim, like the other secretary designees Voss and Fitzgerald have kept dangling, has conducted herself with dignity and the utmost professionalism, showing more patience than the situation deserves. But in their effort to obstruct the governor and exert their political gamesmanship, Voss and Fitzgerald are slighting a good and talented person and the citizens of Wisconsin. Someone in the Republican caucus must have enough integrity to see the pettiness in all this and give Secretary Crim the respect of a confirmation vote.